Temple trying to look downfield. He was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. And that'll set him back five. Stick, second and 15. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Jones, and a short pickup here as he'll get up to about the 22-yard line. On third down, here's Jones, and a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on here to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. This will go to Henry out wide. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Finds his tight end Ingram.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Now a first down throw, Cunningham. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Shot before break. Cunningham is going to fire one deep middle of the field, and it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On the run, it's Bo Jackson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They'll run on first down. Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. On the carry, it's Jackson. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. They'll run with Jackson. And he gets it down to the 32. 125 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. On first down, it's Jackson. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Now Jackson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. They go play action now. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down. From the gun, it's Wilson. Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off by the 13-time Pro Bowler Ray Lewis, and he will take this one home. It's